First of all, three questions should be asked. First, how you get injured? By that, you know the mechanism of injury. Second question, whether you could walk or not after the injury, as it helps to stratify risk of fracture. Third question, previously injured or not, as people who sprained ankle are more likely to be re-injured, and basketball players are more prone to that. Classification of ankle sprain by location: lateral sprain, medial sprain, and syndesmotic sprain. Syndesmotic sprain are also known as high ankle sprain. Mechanism of injury: in case of lateral sprain, there is excessive inversion of plantar flexed foot. In case of medial sprain, there is excessive eversion. And in case of syndesmotic sprain, there is excessive dorsiflexion. Lateral sprain involves ATFL, CFL, and PTFL. ATFL means anterior talofibular ligament, CFL means calcaneofibular ligament, and PTFL means posterior talofibular ligament. ATFL is the most commonly injured ligament, while CFL isolated injury is uncommon. In case of medial sprain, it is infrequent sprain because of strongest medial deltoid ligament, and because of that, medial sprain is mainly associated with avulsion fracture of medial malleolus, while syndesmotic sprain involves anterior, posterior, and transverse tibiofibular ligament. And syndesmotic sprain is associated with chronic ankle instability. Also, it is more recurrent and associated with heterotopic ossification.
Mechanism of injury for ankle sprain: excessive inversion, excessive eversion, and for high ankle sprain, excessive dorsiflexion and or eversion. Talocrural joint line, this is anterior tibiofibular ligament. A indicates anterior talofibular ligament and B indicates calcaneofibular ligament.
Grading of ankle sprain: grade 1, 2, and 3. Grade 1 is associated with microscopic tear of ligament and mild swelling and tenderness. Grade 2, incomplete tears of ligament and moderate swelling, tenderness, and ecchymosis. Grade 3 is associated with complete tear of ligament and severe swelling, tenderness, and ecchymosis. And also there is significant joint instability. In case of grade 1 injury, patient is able to bear weight with minimal pain. In case of grade 2, there is painful ambulation. And in case of grade 3 injury, patient is unable to ambulate. Physical examination for ankle sprain: first, look for swelling and ecchymosis. Second, palpate the entire fibula, distal tibia, foot, and Achilles tendon. Why entire fibula is palpated? Because syndesmotic ankle sprain is associated with fracture of proximal fibula. And in case of tenderness, while palpating Achilles tendon, Thompson test should be performed. And third thing, check for tenderness in areas required for the Ottawa ankle rules. Ottawa ankle rules we will see later on. Site of tenderness indicates specific type of injury and associated fracture. Tenderness over distal tibia or fibula indicates fracture associated with inversion or eversion. Tenderness over ligamentous structures like distal tibiofibular indicates eversion or hyperdoxiflexion injury, which is syndesmosis sprain. without significant swelling. Tenderness over talocrural joint line indicates fracture of osteochondral talar dome, and it is due to direct trauma between talus and fibula or tibia.
There are some special tests for ankle sprain. Two tests for detecting syndesmotic sprain. First, squeeze test for syndesmotic injury. To perform this squeeze test, place a heel of each hand just proximal to the midpoint of the calf and compress the tibia and fibula by squeezing in anterior medial to posterior lateral direction. A positive test is marked by reproduction of pain in distal syndesmosis just above the ankle joint. Second, external rotation stress test. It is a provocative test for syndesmotic injury. The examiner supports the lateral fibula and tibia with one hand and gently forces external rotation with other hand. Pain at distal syndesmosis confirms the distal syndesmotic ligamentous injury. Test for evaluating chronic ankle instability. So, anterior drawer test. This test is performed with patient foot in neutral position, in slight plantar flex and in inversion. The lower leg is stabilized by the examiner one hand, and with the other hand, examiner grasps the heel, while the patient foot rests on the anterior aspect of examiner's arm. The anterior force, the direction of force, is applied to the heel while holding the distal anterior leg fixed. This test suggests an excessive anterior displacement. Second test, talar tilt test. The talar tilt test is for integrity of calcaneofibular ligament. With the ankle in neutral position, the gentle inversion force is applied to the ankle. The degree of inversion is observed and compared to the uninjured side. Deferred examination in case of ankle sprain. It suggests that performing a physical examination 5 days after the injury improves the accuracy of diagnosing ligament rupture. It is important to note down that anterior drawer test and talar tilt test are of limited usefulness in the acute injury when pain, swelling and muscle spasm are present. Imaging modality of choice. First line is X-ray. Anteroposterior, lateral and mortise view of ankle joint. MRI should be considered in ankle sprain that remain painful after 6 to 8 weeks of standard therapy. Ottawa ankle rules. A series of ankle radiograph film is required only if there is any pain in malleolar zone or any of these findings. Bone tenderness at A site, posterior edge or tip of lateral malleolus up to 6 cm. And bone tenderness at B site, posterior edge or tip of medial malleolus up to 6 cm. A series of foot radiograph film is required only if there is any pain in midfoot zone and any of these findings. Bony tenderness at C site, base of 5th metatarsal, and D site, navicular bone. And 13, inability to bear weight both immediately and in the emergency department up to 4 steps. Rules avoids unnecessary imaging, but in case of diabetics and alcoholics, they have already diminished sensitivity to pain. So in that case, Ottawa ankle rules are not applicable. Management of ankle sprain. For the first 2 to 3 days, rise approach. Rest, ice, compression and elevation. Rest by limiting weight bearing. Ice or cold water immersion is recommended for 15 to 20 minutes every 2 to 3 hours for the first 48 hours or until swelling is improved. Compression with an elastic bandage and analgesics can be used, both topical or oral can be effective. Physiotherapy exercise including plantar flexion, dorsiflexion and foot circles. For immobilization in case of grade 3 ankle sprain, lace up ankle brace, air cast or air cushion lower leg splint. Thank you for watching.